the program for today about people taking horse ivermectin. Before we do that, let me go ahead and cover some of the comments about ivermectin. I had a patient send me some information about ivermectin. I had seen a couple of the videos on it. You can't help if you go onto YouTube, at least in my space, to be hit with the video of the doctor appearing in front, I'm blanking on his name, the doctor appearing on in front of the legislature with his impassioned plea for the government to put out ivermectin programs for mass consumption. I went ahead and reviewed that. I reviewed the science, and we're going to talk about that science some today. The science clearly has some good evidence. I think it's a little bit better than what we had for hydroxychloroquine. Again, we'll get into the details. That's actually what this video is about. On April 10th, 2020, the FDA sent a letter to stakeholders about the use of ivermectin, and it said people should never take animal drugs. I saw that and I thought, gosh, the FDA is overreacting again. And then I saw this video that we're going to show you in a few minutes. I don't think they were overreacting. The FDA Center for Veterinary Medicine has recently become aware of increased public visibility of the anti-parasitic drug ivermectin after the announcement of a research article that described the effect of ivermectin on SARS-CoV-2 in a laboratory setting. The antiviral research pre-publication paper, the FDA-approved drug ivermectin, inhibits the replication of SARS-CoV-2 in vitro. It documents how SARS responded to ivermectin when exposed in a petri dish. That's what in vitro means. The FDA is concerned about the health of consumers who may self-medicate by taking ivermectin products intended for animals. According to the FDA, people should never take animal drugs. Ivermectin is an important part of a parasite control program for certain species and should only be given to animals for approved uses or as prescribed by a veterinarian in compliance with the requirements for extra label drug use. Due to potentially elevated interest in ivermectin following the new research, some products may not be available. So let's go back and take a little bit deeper look at some of the research and just, you know, start with what is ivermectin? It's a multifaceted medication. It's widely used. It's FDA approved. It's an anti-parasitic medication. It does have some known antiviral and anti-inflammatory properties. It has been included on the WHO's list of essential medications. So it's not an out there kind of medication. It's something that's on that WHO list. And the things on that list are everyday kind of medications. I have prescribed ivermectin in the past for things like head lice. Ivermectin was identified in the late 70s and first approved for animal use in 1981. Its potential use in humans was confirmed a few years later. It is a what's called a broad spectrum drug with high lipid or fat solubility. It possesses numerous effects on parasites, nematodes, arthropods, flavivirus, mycobacteria, and mammals through a variety of mechanisms. Since 2012, multiple in vitro studies have demonstrated that ivermectin inhibits the replication of many viruses, including influenza, Zika, dengue, yellow fever, and West Nile viruses. Now it's potentially going to prove to be an effective treatment for COVID-19. Maybe effective treatment and maybe an effective preventive. Maybe a little bit too early to say, but again, a lot of interesting information. At a press conference on December 4th, the FLCCC Alliance, this is another group that's called on national health authorities to immediately review medical evidence showing the evidence of ivermectin for the prevention and early treatment of COVID-19. They say they stand for, and this is what FLCCC stands for, Frontline COVID-19 Critical Care Alliance. Over the past several weeks, the FLCCC Alliance conducted a comprehensive review of the rapidly emerging science around, which is at that point 11 studies, demonstrating ivermectin as a potential solution to the unprecedented global surge for the COVID-19 epidemic. Again, go into two of these studies that they listed, number two here and number eight. Study number one, or it's listed on number two on the previous page. It's a June 2020 study. It proposed the mechanism of how ivermectin works. It's the study mentioned in the FDA letter of April 2020. Cells were infected with SARS-CoV-2 for 2 hours prior to DMSO or ivermectin at the indicated concentrations. Samples were given at 0 and 3 days post-infection for quantification of the viral load. A single treatment was able to affect about a 5,000-fold reduction in virus at 48 hours in cell culture. So I don't think anybody's arguing the fact that it has a big impact in the petri dish. The proposal on how SARS-CoV-2 infects the cells, this is where we get into some of the geeky stuff about mechanisms. IMP alpha beta 1. It binds to the coronavirus cargo protein in the cytoplasm and translates it through the NPC or the nuclear core complex. And again, this is just a geek alert. This part won't last very long. But it's very interesting to those of us who are interested in biologically, how does this happen? Basically, what it's doing is keeping the virus mechanism from getting imported into the nucleus of the cell. Back to script, IMP alpha and beta 1 are importins. That means proteins that transport other proteins from the cytoplasm of the cell into the nucleus. Inside the nucleus, the virus important complex then falls apart. At that point, the viral cargo can reduce the host cell's antiviral response, leading to enhanced infection. So again, it's basically disabling a part of the virus's ability to capture the cell and the cell mechanisms for making proteins. So how ivermectin may inhibit SARS-CoV-2? Ivermectin binds to and destabilizes that important protein, IMPORTIN, the protein that transports other proteins across that nucleus membrane. That prevents the importin from binding to the viral protein and prevents it from entering the nucleus. This likely results in reduced inhibition of the antiviral responses, leading to a normal, more efficient antiviral response from that cell. Study number two is the ICON study in October 2020. It showed how ivermectin benefits hospitalized COVID-19 patients. This was many of you who are reading about this and studying it. I believe this was the South Florida study. The study question was this: is ivermectin associated with lower mortality rate in patients hospitalized with coronavirus COVID-19? The results: a retrospective cohort study, consecutive patients hospitalized with confirmed severe acute respiratory distress syndrome from coronavirus 2 infection at a 4-hospital consortium in South Florida. Analysis shows statistically significant lower mortality rates in the group treated with ivermectin as compared to the group treated with the usual care. Now, statistically significant meant 15% versus 25.2%. So the interpretation in this study was that ivermectin was associated with lower mortality during treatment of COVID-19 patients, especially in patients who required higher inspired oxygen or ventilatory support. So this document came from that FLCCC that we talked about. This is their protocols. Outpatient protocol on the right. In other words, you've already got infection and this is what they're recommending you take. Ivermectin, 0.2 milligrams per kilogram on day 1 and 3, 4,000 of vitamin D3, 2,000 of vitamin C 2 or 3 times daily, quercetin and zinc. We've talked about all of these: vitamin D3, vitamin C, quercetin, zinc, melatonin, and aspirin. You see that on both of these. You also see it on their prophylaxis protocol. Continue to get great feedback regarding the webinars. And here's why. You know, on the internet, when you hear a webinar, you expect for somebody to try to sell you something. We're not doing that. We're trying to tell you something. People are coming in with their labs from Quest, inflammation panel, OGTT, insulin survey response, and then they're finding out, do I have inflammation? Do I have insulin resistance? And where does that fit in terms of other folks? We're getting ready to start one for CIMT as well. So again, people are really excited about finding out their own status. Looking forward to seeing you there. Thanks.